Good afternoon, students of class 5. Today I am here with the second part of the explanation of the lesson 22 from your English grammar. We already discussed the first part. The lesson is the tense. So, to revise it, what we have finished in part 1, we have learnt the simple present, simple past, simple future. Then we learned present continuous, past continuous and future continuous. And how the sentences are formed, we already learned, and I suppose you have understood. Those of you who have not understood during the class time, you can ask me for the clarification or to clear out the doubts. So today we'll move on to the third point, means in the category of tense we have we already learned the perfect tense once, just I explained, but all the same I'll explain today. We have the perfect tense. So we have the next point is the perfect perfect tense. In the present perfect tense, we use the subject have or has. Means to say an action that is already been completed. No, already been completed, and this verb is said to be in the present perfect tense. So, an action which is already over. For example, in your book there is it has rained heavily. So it has rained heavily means to say that action is already finished. Raining is over. Now what you have to remember here, in the present perfect tense, first we have the subject that can be noun or a pronoun, plus we have has or have, and we have the third form of the verb. In the plural, they, we, more than two names, we use at a plural form, that is half. So, this the action which is already being completed in the present tense is known as the present perfect tense. Now, we have a present, past perfect, the second one is the past perfect. The past perfect tense, we have subject, can be noun or pronoun, plus had, plus third form of the verb. Rained. No, rain is third form here. Third form of the verb. Third form of the verb. Now, don't get confused with what is third form of the verb. In verb, we have three. First form, that is a base form, then we have that is a present, then we have the second form, that is past tense, then third form is a past participle. For example, most of the verb we have past and second and third form same, but meaning is entirely different. Means it is according up to the sentence it is put. Now for example, write. Some are irregular. Write wrote past tense second form, written is the third form. Okay, walk, walked, walk, walk, walked, walked third form. Eat, ate, eaten. So when we were learning the different forms of verb, we have already learned this. So only third form of the verb you please remember. So we have in the past perfect tense, we have subject plus had plus third form of the verb, and whatever the rest of the things has to be carried on, it will be written. Now the action already had finished, had been finished. This means it's already been finished. Those action or event that is in the sentence is in the past perfect tense. So the use of had in both the singular and plural will be same. You know, I had, we had, she had, it had, all had is a common form. All the nouns and pronouns and for the subject. And the third one we have. All the best up to this lesson we have for the test. Please prepare yourself. MCQs. So be very careful. What is right will be right, wrong will be wrong. You will lose your mark. So think nicely and then get into the formula of all these present, past and future. So it will be easy for you to connect in which tense it belongs. Okay, all the best for you. Learn it, and literature will have a revision work, but here we don't have the time, so I left to you to learn by yourself. So all the best. Thank you.